Hey guys, Brother Kylan here, Pastor Central Baptist Church in my home office, aka the garage. but I want to share with you, first of all, during this Holy Week service, first of all, I want to say thank you on behalf of the Mann family for praying for Everett. We did have a scare over the weekend and we had to rush him to the Bonner, and he had an immediate his appendix removed, and so we're thankful for those workers there at Le Bonheur, and they're very safe, and it was just we praise the Lord, everything worked out okay. We got home late last night. He's very sore today, so just keep praying for the little man, and if it's going to happen, it's going to happen to Everett. But anyway, we're so thankful for that. But this week, it is Monday of the Holy Week, and this week, very quickly, I want us to look at the daily events that led up to the Passion of Christ. And yesterday, we know, was Palm Sunday. And on Palm Sunday, we of course recognize the triumphal entry. But then according to Mark 11, verse 11, it says that Jesus went into the temple and he looked around, and because it was already late, he left. He left after looking around and probably in disgust, as we're going to actually see a little bit today. But he looked around and then it said he left and went to Bethany. Now, Jesus and his disciples spent the night in Bethany, a town about 2 miles east of Jerusalem. This is where Lazarus, whom Jesus had raised from the dead, and his two sisters, Mary and Martha, lived. They were close friends to Jesus, so more than likely, Jesus spent the night there with them, with the disciples. And so now it's Monday, and here we are today, and let's look at the events that occurred on Monday, that we believe occurred on Monday. In Mark chapter 11, if you'll follow along with me, each day, like I said, we're going to be taking about 5 to 10 minutes looking at these lessons, just a little Holy Week time here. But in Mark chapter 11, verse 12 through 19, if you want to turn there and look, but it says this: "Now the next day, when they had come out from Bethany, he was hungry. And seeing from afar a fig tree having leaves, he went to see if perhaps he would find something on it. When he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for it was not the season for figs. In response, Jesus said to it, 'Let no one eat fruit from you ever again.' And his disciples heard it. So they came to Jerusalem. Then Jerusalem went into the temple and began to drive out those who bought and sold in the temple, and overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who sold doves. And he would not allow anyone to carry wares through the temple. Then he taught, saying to them, 'It is not written, is it not written, my house shall be called a house of prayer for all nations, but you have made it a den of thieves.' And the scribes and chief priests heard it and sought how they might destroy him, for they feared him, because all the people were astonished at his teaching. When evening had come, he went out into the city." Now, what a very interesting passage. So this morning, we see two events right here that probably took place on Monday: the cursing of the fig tree and Jesus cleansing the temple. Now, very quickly, I want you to see how these two passages really go together better than we realize. You see, both of these situations point to the fact of how Jesus feels about us going through the motions of religion. And many believe that the curse of the fig tree represented God's judgment on the spiritually dead religious leaders of Israel. Others believe, and I'm actually one of these, that the symbolism extends to all believers, demonstrating that genuine faith is more than just outward religion. True living faith must bear spiritual fruit in a person's life. And this tree looked good from a distance, but it did not bear fruit. Now, Jesus knew that this tree didn't have any figs on it. We know that. The Bible even says at the end of verse 3, "For this, it was not the season for figs." There it was. So he knew. He's the Lord. He knows what seasons they're supposed to bear. But the Bible says that he comes up to it and he realizes it and he curses it. Then when Jesus arrived at the temple, he found the courts full of corrupt money changers, and he began overturning their tables and clearing the temple, saying what he does here in verse 17: "Is it not written, my house shall be called a house of prayer for all nations, but you have made it a den of thieves." And so their temple worship had not been about worship. They were going through the motions, and the spiritual leaders had even made it about them and their financial gain, robbing people by jacking up the prices on the lambs and the doves that people had to purchase to celebrate Passover. And how they would carry this out was, when you go back and you study the history of it, it's pretty interesting. You know, they had to present a perfect spotless lamb or a pair of doves. And so what they would do is they'd come and they'd say, "No, we're not going to accept this." They would purposely find some flaw wrong with it, so they would have to purchase purchase those overpriced lambs and doves. And so we even see their hearts. I mean, their hearts weren't right with God, the scribes and the Pharisees. It weren't. Listen to verse 18 again. It says, "And the scribes and the chief priests heard it and sought how they might destroy him." Wow, that's some people filled with love there, isn't it? No, not at all. So church, let this be a lesson for us today. And may this time of quarantine be a lesson for all of us just to stop and examine ourselves. Are we just going through the motions without bearing any fruit? And have we just been going through the motions to make ourselves feel good or for our own gain? Or are we truly in love with Jesus? You know, we may be looking good on the outside and from a distance, like that fig tree, it looks good. But when someone comes close to examine our branches, are we bearing fruit? Are we doing what we know we're supposed to be doing? May this lesson be a lesson for all of us to examine today. And may we be the church that we need to be during this time. So take this time today, examine yourself, see if once again you are who you're claiming to be. Once again, let's take a lesson here from the fig tree and from the temple and the money changers in the temple, and let's learn what not to do, and let's be the true disciples that God wants us to be. May the Lord bless you this Holy Week, and we'll see you tomorrow. God bless.